So lips today.
I know, it's favourite.
It is. You love a lipstick.
Yeah,
don't
I have
you?
Toned it down though, guys. So you'll be happy to know.
Okay.
Yeah.
We'll start with Eloise. Eloise, she actually doesn't know where to start because you worry about looking like a clown.
Yeah, I never know what colour to go for, and I never can find a nudie type one that suits me.
Suits your skin tone.
Yeah.
Yes, you do have to get it right.
It's
don't
quite
you?
Common that the best thing to do is when you pick up a lipstick, which I've got here. This one's great because it's actually really long lasting as well. It's beautiful, really nice texture. This is a Bourjois one. What I'm going to do is when you pop it on your lip, you can see straight away that this naturally will suit Eloise's lip. Now, because she's quite scared of lipstick, put it on very lightly. You see how I've kind of just done it as a bit of a stain?
Yes.
So, to start off with, just go really, really lightly.
And I you think should... you get... Sorry.
So, go on.
No, I was going to say, I think you get used to wearing colour on your lips. Like, I think
do.
When you don't, when you're not used to it, it's suddenly like a real shock. But actually, once you build up and build up, suddenly you realise that you really need it and you almost can't live without it. You
well,
go
exactly.
the other way.
The thing is this will just give you a bit of a bitten lip look.
It's lovely.
Should she prep her lips beforehand?
Yes. Now, I think I've prepped all the girls' lips beforehand. It's
really
important.
How do you
really
prep
important.
A lip?
I've actually done a little demo, so it's an exfoliator. So it's a bit like a lipstick, and it's got a little bit of sandy texture to it. What you do is just rub it up and down the lips, very gently, and then wipe it with a cotton bud so you get rid of any of the kind of sandy residue. And what that does is just takes off the finest layer of any kind of dry lips, because everyone's getting dry lips, especially this time of the year. So it's really good because it just makes the lipstick last. And then just with a tiny little bit of a wet cotton pad, just wipe it off, and then you're ready to prep.
Mm-hmm.
So to
good.
Go in. Now, the only other thing is, with Eloise, what I'm going to do is, because she's a bit nervous about colour, I've just done a little bit of a stain, but to jazz it up, this is one of my favourite lip glosses. This is a Dazzle lip gloss. Now, I've got a few items which I've said on here which are amazing, but these are the two that I've used. So the Bourjois one, which is a matte velvet, but then this just gives your lips such a shine.
Look at the glitter in that. That's like Barbie's lip gloss.
People will want to kiss these lips, guys. But the thing is, she can wear it on her own if she wants to, or she can pop it on a little bit fuller.
And it just it up.
It's just a really good introduction to lipstick. And then when she feels confident, then you can go with brighter tones.
Beautiful. Thank you very much.